Today on Seasonings, we're talking about black and green cardamom. Black and green cardamom are related. They are both plants that are part of the ginger family. And black cardamom comes from one of these two plants. And green cardamom comes from one of these plants. While they're both from the same family and they're both called cardamom, you use them differently. So we're gonna start with black cardamom. You don't see black cardamom as much in North America. It's a larger pod. It has a very, very smoky smell, and that comes from the way that it's processed. And black cardamom is really fantastic in soups and stews, beef marinades, meat rubs, barbecue sauces. It is something that you can either grind the entire pod and use it all, or if you want a little bit more delicate flavor, you can break the pod open and only grind the seed on the inside. I wouldn't use this in any sweet dishes, only savory dishes, and only really strongly flavored savory dishes. Something that can really stand up to the amazingly strong flavor of this. Black cardamom is also known as hill cardamom, Bengal cardamom, greater cardamom, Nepal cardamom, winged cardamom. It's got a pile of different names. Black cardamom is also great paired with things like basil, fennel, garlic, lemongrass, and of course, because it's part of the ginger family, anything with ginger. That brings us to green cardamom. And green cardamom is a little bit different in that it works well in sweet and savory dishes. Green cardamom is native to India. You see it in a lot of Indian spice mixes, garam masala. You see it in masala chai. You see it in cooking from other parts of the world. It is a major component of soups, stews, beef dishes, meat dishes. You see it in puddings, cakes, breads. This really is a very versatile spice. Now you can use it whole, or you can grind the whole pod, or you can break it open and grind just the seeds inside. There's a couple of spice markets that we go to where you can buy just the seeds without the pods. Usually a recipe will specify what they want, and if they don't specify, then they want you to grind or use the whole pod. Now there is a white cardamom, and you see white cardamom in a lot of Scandinavian cooking. And the deal with that is it's just green cardamom that's bleached. Initially, the long travel time from India to Scandinavia, the pods bleached on their own in the months of travel. And at this point, though, it's just done chemically. And it's found a home in Scandinavia, and they continue to use white cardamom because they don't want the color in the dishes that they're cooking. It changes the flavor a little bit, too. Of course, you lose some of the flavor components in that bleaching process. Now both green and black cardamom are known as warming spices. I'm gonna say that you've experienced green cardamom in a lot of different dishes. So I would suggest that you go out and get some black cardamom and really experiment with it. It's less well known, and I think that this will help a lot of your deep, earthy, savory dishes sort of get to that next level.